So if you're concerned about leukemia as a diagnosis, often the two things that are most common that can often be incredibly instructive are a physical exam and a complete blood count, or CBC.
Because leukemia is crowding out normal cells, on a CBC you will often see that you have a low white blood cell count or way too high white blood cell count. The patient might be anemic and then not have enough platelets.
The gold standard for diagnosing leukemia in the vast majority of kids is going to be a bone marrow aspirate and a bone marrow biopsy. And that involves taking a needle that's about the size of a ballpoint pen. And most typically, we would insert that needle under anesthesia for most kids, with some numbing medicine that's put on the back of the hip. There are a number of tests that we do on that bone marrow sample to both adequately diagnose the disease, to define the best treatment plan and organization, and also to predict the likelihood of cure. And we have answers within a few days for families to really refine what kind of leukemia it is. Is it what we would call high risk or low risk based on some biologic features? And then what are the odds of cure and how are we going to treat it? The other thing that's done with the diagnosis of leukemia is that children get a spinal tap. It's an important thing for us to know if there are leukemia cells that might be hiding out in your spinal fluid so that we know exactly how aggressively to treat your spinal fluid. Not every kid that gets a CBC should have a spinal tap, and not every kid that gets a bone marrow test has leukemia. So it's important to do this in an orderly, kind of sequential way so that you can assess the information, that you can talk through it with providers, and you understand exactly what test is most appropriate at that time.
The first conversation that I have with a family and an older child who wants to listen or can understand is we talk about what leukemia is. We spend a lot of time in that first week of reassuring them that we are here, that we're watching them really carefully, that we can meet to any needs that should come up. Reassuring them that I'm willing to sit and answer the same question 100 times if that's really what it takes, because it is, you can't hear, you can't know anything beyond the word cancer.